Hello everyone, welcome to StudyIQ. In this video, I will bring to you the current affairs of 9th of July. So by now you would be knowing that yesterday it was my 32nd birthday and I received a lot of love and support from you yesterday, thousands of messages. I am indebted to all of you and I hope that I can serve you in future with the same energy. On that note, 8th of July current affairs will be uploaded right after this video, that is 9th of July. First I will cover 9th of July and only then will I cover the yesterday's backlog. So let's start the video. Today I have 5 questions for quiz, not 10, 5 are enough, and these are pretty latest ones from June, from the month of June 2019. What is the name of the cryptocurrency launched by Facebook? What is the name of the new currency that has been recently launched by the West African countries? According to United Nations, India will overtake China to become the world's most populated country by which year? Which state will construct smart Gaushala? Okay, Gaushala is nothing but the cow shelter. Smart Gaushala. Chief Minister Yuva Sambal Yojana is a scheme of which state? So now let's start the today's current affairs. Which country has won the Copa America? So Copa America is won by powerful Brazil. Powerful only in terms of football, okay? Not in terms of economy. So Brazil, they defeated Peru by a score of 3-1. And this achievement is special because Brazil were playing without their best player, Neymar. So they won the Copa America. They are the champions of South America. Clear? And who is Brazil's coach? His name is Tite. So Tite is Brazil's coach. Bicycle sharing scheme. It will be launched by which union territory? Bicycle sharing scheme will be launched by Pondicherry. And one bicycle sharing scheme is also by West Bengal also. The name is Sabuj Sathi. It was praised by United Nations. Sabuj Sathi. V. Naranaswamy, he is the Chief Minister of Pondicherry. And Kiran Bedi is the Lieutenant Governor. Name the Indian sprinter. Sprinter, the word we use for the runner, the fast runner, like for the small races, like 100 meter, 200 meter. And she is very famous for 200 meter. She has been a world champion. So she recently won her second international gold at Kutno Athletics Meet in Poland. What is her name? Her name is of course Hima Das, also called Dhing Express from Assam. So this is her second gold medal in 1 week. One more thing you remember, national champion and national record holder, Muhammad Anas. Muhammad Anas, he also won the gold medal in the men's 200 meter. So women's 200 meter and men's 200 meter both were won by Indians. Which political leader recently shared a blog on water conservation which is called A Daughter, A Tree and A Teacher? I repeat, A Daughter, A Tree and A Teacher. So the blog was shared by Narendra Modi. And basically this blog is about how we can conserve water using our age-old practices. And our Minister for Water Conservation, Jal Shakti is the name of the ministry. Is Gajendra Singh Shekhawat. Constituency is Jodhpur. Recently, the government of India has started Jal Shakti Abhiyan to conserve water, which will target 256 water-stressed districts. Remember, by 2020, 21 Indian cities, 21 big Indian cities will run out of groundwater, like Hyderabad, Bengaluru, Delhi. And by 2030, 40% of India will have no access to drinking water. This is what the Niti Aayog report says. Which indigenous aircraft carrier will be delivered to the Indian Navy in 2021 for an advanced trial? Now you know that India has only one aircraft carrier, Vikramaditya. Vikramaditya is India's only aircraft carrier. Now we are also building one more called Vikrant. It will be delivered by 2021. Right now, it is undergoing trials. One more we are making with the help of Britain, it is called INS Vishal. Now remember, INS Vishal will also be an aircraft carrier. Which manufacturing plant has been inducted in the list of World Economic Forum's Global Lighthouse Network? It is Tata Steel in Kalinganagar. Tata Steel, it is the first and only Indian manufacturing plant to be included in this list. The lighthouses, what is the meaning of lighthouses? So lighthouses network, it is a community of manufacturers chosen for their immense leadership in the fourth industrial revolution, technology. Basically, the companies that are doing very good in the fourth industrial revolution technology, they are included in the Lighthouses Network. World Economic Forum chairman is Klaus Schwab. Another important thing, if you want to invest in gold, then now you can do so because sovereign gold bond scheme has started. The second issue has started. And if you want to buy gold, then the government has basically issued the prices also. So series 2 is now open for grabs from July the 8th to July the 12th. Remember, the minimum investment that you can do in the sovereign gold bond is 1 gram. Okay. And the maximum is 4 kg. 4 kg is for the individuals and the Hindu undivided family. And if you are a trust, then up to 20 kg you can invest. And this question has been asked a lot of times, that what is the maximum and minimum investment in a sovereign gold bond? Minimum 1 gram, maximum 4 gram for individuals, for HUF, but 20 kg for the trusts. Now, there is a book which has been released in 10 languages by President Ramnath Kovind yesterday. It is called Viveka Deepini. Now, this book was originally written in some other language. And who wrote it? So, original book was written by Adi Shankaracharya. Adi Shankaracharya in the form of questions and answers. And now it has been converted into 10 languages. Who has been appointed as the country manager for India by LinkedIn? LinkedIn was acquired by Microsoft 2 years back, if you remember. LinkedIn is a product of Microsoft. And Asutosh Gupta is the India head now for LinkedIn. Which badminton player has won the Canada Open men's single title? It is won by Li Shifeng. And Li Shifeng is Chinese. Li Shifeng. And Li Shifeng defeated Parupalli Kashyap in the final. Defense Research Development Organization has successfully tested Nag missile. Nag missile is a what type of missile? Nag missile is a anti-tank guided missile. Now remember, Nag is a very important missile. It is manufactured by the DRDO program. And you know, this missile has a helicopter variant also called Helina. So this is a missile which can be fired from a aircraft, that is Nag. It can be fired from a helicopter, which is called Helina. In fact, there is a variant of this missile which can be even fired from your shoulder. You can carry it on your shoulder and you can fire it. And that version is called Man Portable Anti-Tank Guided Missile, MPATGM. The weight of this shoulder variant is only 14.5 kg, so that a soldier can carry it on the shoulder. 14.5 kg is the weight. Nag. DRDO chairman is G. Satish Reddy. PopShot. PopShot is an interactive browser built recently in which country? PopShot. It has been built in India. Okay, it has been launched in India recently. Board of Control for Cricket in India has appointed which person as the head of cricket at the National Cricket Academy? Rahul Dravid has been appointed as the head of the National Cricket Academy. Who has overtaken Lionel Messi to become the second highest international goal scorer? Second highest is Sunil Chhatri. Sunil Chhatri. And number one is Cristiano Ronaldo. Which South African player has announced retirement from one-day matches? South African player. His name is Imran Tahir. Imran Tahir. Remember, JP Dumini. There is another player called JP Dumini. South African, he has announced his retirement. And recently, Shoaib Malik also announced his retirement. Indian Army is buying Excalibur guided long-range artillery ammunition from which country? It can strike the targets more than 50 km away. Very powerful Excalibur guided artillery. India is buying it from America. United States of America. Who has become the second fastest Indian to take 100 wickets in one-day matches? Second fastest Indian is Jasprit Bumrah to take 100 wickets in one-day matches. First one is Mohammad Shami. So Mohammad Shami is the record holder. Mohammad Shami took it in his 56th match. Jasprit Bumrah has taken just one match more, 57th one-day match. But all-time record holder is Rashid Khan. Rashid Khan has taken 100 wickets in one-day matches in only 44 matches. So world record holder is Rashid Khan. From India, Mohammad Shami is number 1 and Jasprit Bumrah is now number 2. The question can also be asked, which was the 100th wicket of Jasprit Bumrah? It's a good question. So, Dimuth Karunaratne, the captain of Sri Lanka. Dimuth Karunaratne was the 100th dismissal of Jasprit Bumrah. World's largest burn and plastic surgery institute was inaugurated in which country? It was recently inaugurated in Dhaka. Dhaka is in Bangladesh. And India's largest cancer institute was opened in Haryana in a place called Jhajjar. International Olympic Committee has removed the ban on Olympic Committee of which country? The ban has been lifted from Kuwait. Kuwait. So this was the video of today. Now quickly, I will tell you the answers of the quiz. Cryptocurrency launched by Facebook is called Libra. West African countries have launched a new currency called ECO, ECO, ECO. According to UN, India will overtake China by 2027 in population. Smart Gaushalas are being made by Madhya Pradesh. Yuva Sambal Yojana is a Yojana of Rajasthan. Rajasthan. So that's it for today. I will see you in the video of 8th of July and then 10th of July. Thank you so much and take care.